Hi, this is Ms. Hodges, and I want you to hear one of my favorite stories, Dr. DeSoto by William Stegg. Dr. DeSoto, the dentist, did very good work, so he had no end of patients. Those close to his own size, moles, chipmunks, etc., sat in the regular dentist's chair. Larger animals sat on the floor, while Dr. DeSoto stood on a ladder. For extra large animals, he had a special room. There, Dr. DeSoto was hoisted up to the patient's mouth by his assistant, who also happened to be his wife. Dr. DeSoto was especially popular with the large animals. He was able to work inside their mouths, wearing rubbers to keep his feet dry, and his fingers were so delicate and his drill so dainty, they could hardly feel any pain. Being a mouse, he refused to treat dangerous animals that was dangerous to mice, and it said so on his sign. He wouldn't even admit the most timid-looking cat. One day, when they looked out, they saw a well-dressed fox wearing a flannel bandage around his jaw. "I cannot treat you," said Dr. DeSoto. "Haven't you read my sign?" "Please," the fox wailed, "have mercy, I'm suffering." And he wept so bitterly, it was pitiful to see. "Just a moment," said Dr. DeSoto. "That poor fox, what shall we do?" "Let's risk it." So his wife pressed a button and let the fox in. He was up the stairs in a flash. "Bless your little hearts," he cried, falling to his knees. "I beg you, do something. My tooth is killing me." "Sit on the floor, sir, and remove the bandage." Dr. DeSoto climbed up the ladder and bravely entered into the fox's mouth. Oh. The fox had a rotten tooth and unusually bad breath. "That tooth must come out," said Dr. DeSoto. "But I'll have you a brand new one tomorrow." "Just stop the pain," whimpered the fox, wiping some tears away. Despite his misery, he realized he had a tasty little morsel in his mouth, and his jaw began to quiver. "Keep open," yelled Dr. DeSoto. "Wide open," yelled his wife. "I'm giving you some gas now. You won't feel a thing." The fox was in dreamland. How I love them raw, just with a pinch of salt and a little white dry wine. They could have guessed what he was dreaming about. So Mrs. DeSoto handed her husband a pole to keep the fox's mouth open. Dr. DeSoto fastened the extractor to the bad tooth. Then he and his wife began turning the wrench. Finally, with a sucking sound, the tooth popped right out. "I'm bleeding," the fox yelped as he came to. Dr. DeSoto ran up the ladder and stuffed some gauze in the hole. "The worst is over," he said. "I'll have your brand new tooth ready. Be here by 11 sharp." The fox was still woozy and said goodbye. On his way home, he wondered if it was shabby to eat the DeSotos when the job was done. After office hours, Dr. DeSoto and his wife molded the tooth of pure gold, raw with salt, he said. "How foolish of me to trust a fox." His wife said, "Why would he harm us? We're trying to help him." "Because he's a fox and they are all wicked." That night, the DeSotos lied awake worrying. "Should we let him in tomorrow?" "Once I start a job," said the dentist, "I must finish it. My father was the same way, but we must do something to protect ourselves." So they talked and talked, and then they came up with a plan, and then later they went fast asleep. The next morning, promptly at 11, a very cheerful fox turned up. When Dr. DeSoto got in his mouth, he snapped it shut. Then he opened it and just laughed. Dr. DeSoto said, "Be serious, we have work to do." His wife was lugging the heavy tooth up the ladder. "Oh, I love it. Oh, it's beautiful." The fox caressed his brand new tooth. "But we're not finished," said Dr. DeSoto. holding up a large jug. I have a remarkable penetration developed only recently by my wife and me. With one application, you can be rid of toothaches forever. Would you like to be the first? Oh, yes, I certainly would. I hate any kind of personal pain. Remember, you will never have to see us again. No one will see you two again, Def Fox thought to himself. He had definitely made up his mind. He was going to eat them. Dr. DeSoto stepped into the fox's mouth with a bucket of secret formula and proceeded to paint each tooth. His wife stood there making sure that he didn't miss any spots. The fox looked extremely happy. When the job was done, he stepped out. Now, close your jaws tight, he said, and keep them closed for a full minute. The fox did what he was told. Then when he tried to open his mouth, his teeth were stuck together. Oh, excuse me, said Dr. DeSoto. I forgot to tell you. You won't be able to open your mouth for a day or two. The secret formula must first penetrate the dentine. But don't worry, no more pain. The fox was stunned. He stared at Dr. DeSoto and then at his wife. They smiled and waited. All he could say was, thank you very much, through his clenched teeth. And he got up and he left. He tried to do it in a dignified manner. Then he stumbled down the stairs in a daze. Dr. DeSoto and his assistant had out Fox the Fox. They kissed each other and took the rest of the day off. I hope you enjoyed my story, Dr. DeSoto, but you don't have to take my word. Get a good book and read.